Good evening. Today, China has achieved one more milestone by becoming the first country to launch the marine lizard. So this is like, you know, an amphibious vessel so that can travel in both on the water and over the land. So this is first of its kind in the world, and China achieved this. It has been tested very successfully. And when it comes to this particular marine lizard, the so-called marine lizard, it can travel up to 1200 kilometers without a break. It can travel on the waters and also on the land. And it can, you know, this while traveling on the waters, so for a very short distance. So it can travel on the waters, then it can also travel on the land. And its speed is 20 kilometers per hour. And analysts are saying very clearly that China wanted to occupy Taiwan. For quite long period of time, China is demanding that Taiwan is an integral part of China. And now China wants to very seriously take over Taiwan. But because of the internal, external pressure, international pressure, China is holding back. But now, or you know, sometime later, China may try to conquer over and add this Taiwan to the integral part of the China. So we need to wait and watch for those developments. But whatever it is, in the examination tomorrow, there may be a question, what is marine lizard? And which is the first country in the world to launch this? So these are the possible questions. Fine. So now I'll open the document and show you the document that is related to marine lizard. Kindly have a look at this. China has successfully tested the world's first armed amphibious drone boat, which is Chinese military analysts claimed could be used in land assault operations and is capable of forming a combat triad with aerial drones and other drone ships, according to the media reports. So this is going to add a great strength to Chinese military system. So this is built by Wuchang Shipbuild Industry Group under China Shipbuilding Industry Corporation. And please remember, the drone ship is named as Marine Lizard. Please remember these two words, Marine Lizard. And it has operation range of 1200 kilometers, and the Marine Lizard can be remotely controlled via satellites. Very, 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 very important. And when it comes to, you know, this at the time of approaching the land, this amphibious drone ship can release four continuous track units hidden under its belly and travel at 20 kilometers an hour on land. Very, 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 very important one. This is really a powerful one. And what exactly China is planning with this, we need to wait and watch. But for our examination, what is important? What is a marine lizard? And which is the first country to test it successfully? Right? These two are the possible questions for our examination. And when it comes to India, today we also, you know, successfully tested Nirbhay. So Nirbhay is a cruise missile, and it can hit the target which is 1000 kilometers away. It has been tested very successfully today, and please remember, so this is completely developed indigenously, and it has been announced by DRDO. Please remember, what is Nirbhay, right? So this is important for the examination. Next, another very important thing with respect to model code of conduct. What is MCC? What is model code of conduct? So we have already discussed in the last week's class. On the basis of this model code of conduct, Election Commission has the power to take disciplinary action against a political party, against a candidate who is contesting in the elections. So, but now why we are discussing about this? So today, two important people who belong to Uttar Pradesh, One is the Chief Minister, Mr. Yogi Adityanath, and second one is BSP leader, Ms. Mayawati. So these two, on these two people, Election Commission took disciplinary action, and Mr. Yogi Adityanath has been banned to take part in the campaigning for 72 hours, whereas Ms. Mayawati has been banned for campaigning for 48 hours. And these are the two leaders. These are the two leaders. So who made controversial comments on the religious issues. So definitely what happens even under normal circumstances also, speaking over contentious religious issues that will hurt the sentiments of certain people. And this is the very sensitive time in India because, you know, we are the largest democratic country in the world and we are the highest secular country in the world. And at the same time, elections are happening. And during this particular sensitive stage in India, if somebody makes a controversial comment, then what will happen? That will disturb the system of law and order in the country. And even after that, Election Commission did not take action. That is the reason why some of the advocates in the Supreme Court, they raised the voice in the Supreme Court and requested the Supreme Court to issue an order to Election Commission so that Election Commission will take action against these two leaders. Immediately after that one, Supreme Court asked Election Commission, you are a constitutional authority and you have the power to take disciplinary action for the violation of the model code of conduct. But why didn't you do that? It was the question that was raised by Supreme Court. And after that, within 2 hours, Election Commission took the action on these two people. Very, 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 very important. And with respect to Yogi Adityanath, this is not the first time. Second time, after the intervention of the Supreme Court, action has been taken. So for the coming 72 hours, starting from tomorrow morning, Mr. Yogi Adityanath cannot take part in campaigning and Ms. Mayawati cannot take part in campaigning for 48 hours. So now you must be thinking, what will happen with this? Because, you know, these two are the important leaders of their respective political parties in the concerned states. And obviously, if the main leaders are not there in the campaigning, so there will be definitely, you know, that charisma will not be there in the campaigning. And especially when it comes to people like Mayawati, who is a very, very, very popular person, and she herself is BSP. And when herself is not permitted for campaigning, definitely that will be a big blow to the political party. That is the reason why all people, especially the political people, they must maintain restraint, especially when the elections are happening. Otherwise, you know, the action has to be taken. And please remember, with respect to Election Commission, maybe with respect to electronic voting machine, or VVPATs, lots of issues are coming up now. And in some states, some political parties are saying that Election Commission is biased. Election Commission is taking the side of a political party and it's taking action only against some other political parties. So these are all the very dangerous scenario or phenomenon with respect to the largest democratic country in the world. And we expect that Election Commission has to be very independent. Its responsibility is to conduct the free, fair and impartial elections. Fine. And that is the reason why some people are demanding that in Election Commission, there is a necessity of reforms. Fine. Now, what is happening? Straight away, the Chief Election Commissioner and other election commissioners are appointed by the President of India on the recommendation of the Council of Ministers headed by the Prime Minister. So some people are demanding that there should be something like a collegium system. What exactly happens in Supreme Court? Similarly, you need to have a separate body that will recommend for the members to be appointed in the Election Commission. Hope that day will be coming soon. But otherwise, please remember today's important points. With respect to India, this is Nirbhay. With respect to China, this is Marine Lizard. And with respect to elections, this is the Supreme Court intervened today. And it is the Election Commission that took action against Mr. Yogi Adityanath and also Ms. Mayawati. So that's all for the day. And one more thing is that day after tomorrow, that is on April 17th, 2019, I am going to announce a batch for Group 2 and Group 3 of Telangana State Public Service Commission, TSPSC Group 2 and Group 3, the two Telugu medium batch I am going to announce, right? So the students, you know, who are interested in this one, so you may just join the seminar on 17th April. So thank you so much for being with me this evening. I wish you all a very, 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 very good luck. Take very good care. Good night.